Hello everyone. In today's video, again, we are going to discuss about rational numbers as decimals. So before starting with today's video, I would like to recall what we have discussed in my previous video. So in my previous video, I have already discussed with you all what is a rational number and what is the decimal form and how can we convert a rational number in the decimal form without actually doing the long division. So if you will remember, in my previous video, I gave you an important point which says that every rational number can be expressed in decimal form. So now, moving forward, in my previous video, I gave this point that every rational number can be expressed in the decimal form. So now the question arises, but what kind of decimal form it can be written in? What is that form? Are there different types? So the answer is yes, there are different types. So today we will discuss about the different types of decimal forms. So what are these different types? So there are two types of decimal forms. It has been divided into two categories. One is terminating decimals and the other is non-terminating. And these non-terminating decimals, they are further divided into two categories. So one is repeating, or we can also call them as recurring decimals, and the other is non-repeating, or we can call them as non-recurring. So now to begin our discussion, I will first talk about the terminating decimal form. So terminating decimal form, as the name suggests, where the division terminates. In terminating decimal form, the digits after decimal terminates. So examples are 0.53. Another example could be 3.91. You can see here clearly in both the examples, the digits after the decimal are terminating. The division is ended here. So in terminating, we can say the division ends. Now coming to the another category, non-terminating. In non-terminating, we are first going to talk about repeating or recurring. As the name suggests, repeating, which keeps on repeating, which comes again and again. Recurring, which keeps on coming again and again, which reoccurs. So an example of recurring or repeating decimal would be 0.66666. You can see it's going on and on and on. Another example could be 2.99999. Again, it's going on and on and on. So now the question is, does it mean only one digit can repeat? So the answer is no. Something like 3.141414 and so on will also be a repeating or recurring decimal number. Here you can clearly see two digits after the decimal place are repeating. So now the question is, does it mean the repeating part starts immediately after the decimal? Again, the answer is no. So another example is 5.45939393. You can see here. So you can see that immediately after the decimal, the digits are 4, 5 and they are not repeating. But the digits following 4, 5, which is 939393, yes, they are repeating. So yes, it's not necessary that the repeating part starts immediately after the decimal. Now we are moving to the next category. So the next category of the number is non-repeating and non-terminating. So as the name suggests, non-repeating means they do not repeat. So here, no repetition is there. They do not repeat. And secondly, the digits after the decimal point, they form no pattern. There is no particular pattern in the digits after the decimal. So basically, the terminating decimals and repeating or recurring decimals, they together form the category of rational numbers. And non-terminating and non-repeating, they together form the category of irrational numbers, which will be taught later on. So I hope this video helps you to understand the difference between the terminating, non-terminating, repeating or recurring decimals and non-terminating, non-repeating decimals. Thank you.